when I was diagnosed with cancer, I didn't feel sick. You know, I didn't feel like there was anything wrong with me. And I was going to have some surgery, and then that would be, they would get rid of it, and that would be that. But in the course of the surgery, they then found cancer in the lymph nodes, which means that it potentially had spread. So that necessitated chemotherapy.
Well, lots of people who are diagnosed with cancer will have a treatment called chemotherapy. And chemotherapy actually attacks the cancer cells in the body. But in doing so, it also attacks healthy cells. And a side effect of this is sometimes hair loss.
Losing my hair, that then, you know, I thought I'm going to look like a cancer victim.
Some people do lose all of their body hair, and this can happen quite gradually, or it can be quite sudden in some cases. Others maybe don't even lose all of the hair on their head, so it is very different for everyone.
4 days after the second treatment, my head was just really itching, and I decided to wash it. And as I was washing it, it literally came out in my hands like a mop, and it was a most shocking experience, you know, to just see it like that. You know, with hindsight, I probably would have got it cut really short like this, you know, as a preparation. But of course, that would have been difficult at the time.
I think there are lots of different options in terms of coping with the concept of losing hair. People do cope with it very differently, and some people are very open about it and may choose to actually shave off all their hair right from the start and be very honest about what's happening. But others want things to appear as normal as possible, so they might choose to wear a wig every day. Others might want to wear a wig and alternate it with a scarf, maybe when they're at home.
If you get your hair cut short, I would really suggest getting a little sleeping cap so that it's not all in your bed when it starts coming out, because that's quite distressing.
There is something called a cold cap. The way it works is that it actually cools the blood supply to the hair follicles, and this can actually mean that less chemicals reach the hair follicles, potentially causing less hair loss. Now, this does work really well for some people, not so well for others. It's very dependent on the treatment given and the dosage of treatment given. But if you are interested, you can actually talk to your specialist or your chemo nurse about how suitable it might be for you.
It works by, they pump, you know, refrigerator stuff into it, and it freezes your head, basically. It goes down to about -6 degrees. And you sit there with it on for about 4 hours. I mean, quite a long time. And it didn't really work for me. You know, it didn't work for me. And by the third, after the second chemotherapy, about half of my hair fell out. So I didn't bother with it after that. And I have to say, it was a great relief.
Yeah. Many people do find that they lose their eyebrows and eyelashes as well as losing their hair. And makeup such as eyeliner, false eyelashes and eyebrow pencils can help here. Lots of centres do run workshops to help with these techniques.
The answer to all of this was to wear a lot of makeup, you know, to wear lots of lipstick, eyeshadow. I could draw my eyebrows on with a pencil, and the eyelashes, there's not much you can do about it, but eyeliner sort of makes a big difference. So it gives that impression of something being there.
There are lots of sources of support out there. People can certainly talk to their specialist, their healthcare provider. Lots of women tell us they find it very helpful to talk to other women who are in a similar situation. Similarly, there's lots of information on the Breast Cancer Care website about hair loss, and also contact details for local support groups.
It becomes about sort of making it part of my outfit rather than, you know, thinking, oh, how am I going to disguise the fact that I'm bald? You know, it's more, how am I going to integrate that into my whole look? And that really worked for me. And I think that's a, you know, it's a good approach.
For more information, visit www.nhs.uk.